Welcome to My Hometown, the program that explores clubs, organizations, businesses, and issues across Nassau and Suffolk counties and sheds light on the different towns that are making a difference.
A great day to you and welcome to another edition of My Hometown. I'm your host, Bill Horan, along with Nassau Community College student Zac Turkel. Our special guest today is Frank Lazzaro, White House Floral Director. Frank, welcome to our show.
Thank you, Bill.
Now, you've got to tell us, how did you become the White House Freelance Floral Director?
Well, it was very easy back in those days.
When is those days? Tell us what we're
talking about. I was saying in the early 70s.
Okay.
I was stationed at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. I was on active duty. And it was toward Christmas time. And my CO got me into the office, and he says, "Sergeant Lazzaro, we need a Christmas tree in the day room." I said, "Sir, I have no money to get any decorations." He says, "Well, use your imagination. You're a sergeant in the United States Army, and we want a tree, and we want it by 1,800 hours. So I told the guys in the barracks, "We got to do something, guys, because if not, I'm going to be shipped to Alaska." And so we went out during the night, and we chopped down a little evergreen tree about 4 feet high. And, you know, Fort Bragg has millions of trees. No one's going to miss one tree. So we put it into the barracks.
You'll probably get a bill after the show for that tree.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I know. I think she will. It was a lady's front lawn.
We have a troublemaker here. So.
Uh-oh, yeah.
Well, you know, in the Army in those days, we were so risk-takers.
Now, this was when, the 70s?
In the 70s.
Okay.
So, we decorated the tree, and I had no money for decorations. I wanted to take a picture. We had no money for a camera. We were broke. In those days, we made $90, $92 a month. So, I said, "What's green? What's green?" And so we could use the decoration. Army socks. So, I told the guys in the barracks, "Okay, give me your clean Army socks, or brand new ones, and we'll put it on the tree." "Now, what's silver and gold?" "A Schaefer beer." So we drank the beer and put the beer cans on the tree. It was a beautiful military tree. My CO loved it. He said, "You should decorate the tree at the command general office, the commanding officer of Fort Bragg." And it stayed in my mind. After military service, I went on reserve duty, and then I took a part-time job at Kennedy Airport Flower Shop as a delivery man. Back in those days, you could just go to the plane with a corsage box and give it to the customer. No problems, no inspection, nothing. On TWA, on Eastern Airlines, in the IAB building at Kennedy Airport. So I was a delivery man, going to on all the planes, handing them out boxes of corsages. And then I was on a break, and I looked at the FTD magazine that the trade the stores have, and I noticed Mrs. Nixon next to a 20-foot tree in the White House. I said, "My God, the White House has a very big tree." So that month was August, and Nixon resigned from the White House, and the Fords came in, the Ford administration came in. He took over, and he was vice president and became president. I had the idea, let me write Mrs. Ford a letter. It's only 4 months away till Christmas. She's going to need help decorating that place. It's big, I'm sure. I had no idea the White House had a tree 20 feet high. So I wrote her a letter. "Mrs. Ford, I'm Sergeant Frank Lazzaro, United States Army veteran. I said, if you need help decorating your tree, give me a call. I just got discharged from the military, and I'm looking for something on the side."
"If you need help to the White House decorating your tree, give me a call."
"What's that?" "Yeah."
"You said to them, if you need help,
if you need help,
just give me a call."
"Give me a call." As if it was my aunt I'm supposed to be.
"And maybe if they want a sandwich, too, you bring it or something."
"I'll bring lasagna." "Yeah. Anything." So, a month passed, 2 months passed. It's late September. And I lived on Liberty Avenue on top of my dad's little tiny office, real estate office. And we had railroad rooms. My mother was making me lunch. And the telephone rang. So my mother said, "Oh, Frankie, it's probably one of your girlfriends. They call all the time." Back in those days, I was a good-looking guy. So she goes into the other room, which was railroad rooms. Railroad rooms was like one after the other. And I hear her on the phone, and she's a little tiny lady. You know, my mother was a little old-fashioned tiny lady with an apron on all the time. And I hear her say, "What White House is this?" And she had no idea because I never told her. And she thought it was the White House down the block, the funeral home, the court and Shredder. So the voice says, no, it's not that White House. So then I said to myself, well, who's she talking about? And then it clicked on me, the letter. They got my letter. So I went into the other room. I said, Mama, give me the phone. It's the White House. Oh, my God, Frankie, what did you do? Didn't you pay your taxes in the Army? She was so nervous. She said, my son's a good boy. Don't take him back into the Army. We need him here. So she thought I was getting called back into the Army. So I told her, let me speak to the man, please, Ma. I know who it is. So on the other end was the chief White House florist, Mr. Rusty Young. He was appointed by Mamie Eisenhower and to be the first, Jackie Kennedy, I'm sorry. He was appointed by Jackie Kennedy to be the first chief White House florist. And he says, Mr. First Lady got your letter, and she wants to commission you to decorate the tree in the White House.
Just based on that letter. That's like a baseball team signing me or you to be their center fielder.
She got the letter, and on the envelope outside was the old slogan from the 1970s, hire the vet, it's the best bet you'll ever get. That was the slogan we had, because we came back to no jobs.
Wow.
So it caught her attention. I'm sure the secretary saw it and passed it right on to her. And then I went down for the interview with the chief White House florist. And the Secret Service was investigating me in the meantime. I had no idea this was all going on. And on December 6th, I got there. And you can see it on my website, franklazzaro.com. Of my first Christmas tree at 25 years old, decorating on the ladder. And it was the biggest thrill in my life.
This is all from a letter that you wrote to the White House.
A handwritten letter.
Come on down. You're going to be the floral director for the...
Well, they answered it on a telephone. They didn't return it in a letter.
I don't care how they did it. You got the job.
Oh, yeah. I got the job.
Oh, my God.
Incredible. It was so exciting. I made news overnight, national news, because it went up. The next day, news sent to four. You remember Tony Guider and Pia Lindstrom? Pia Lindstrom came to my home with the news television crew after they confirmed it at the White House. Is this going to be the White House? Yes, it is. All the television crew came upstairs. Now, we have a small four-room apartment. How are you going to fit all? Meanwhile, my mother got so excited, she started making lasagna for them.
Oh, I would come to your house for lasagna. Zach's always
there.
My mother says they got to eat Frankie before they start the interview. You know?
Actually, that made it even more real and more personal. It's just amazing. Zach, did you have a question?
Yeah, Frank, we all know this happened in the 1970s, specifically 1976, right? Or 1974?
No, it was earlier. 1974, mm-hmm. In the fall.
Okay. Frankie, where were you? Frank.
It's okay. Frankie's cool. He'll call me. Yeah. Mrs. Ford called me Frankie one time.
I don't know why I got that stuck in my head, but Frank, where were you born and raised?
I was born and raised in Jamaica, Queens, New York. I never left Queens until I went into the Army. I never knew what a cow looked like, you know? I'm a Jamaica boy all my life in South Ozone Park, Richmond Hill High School I went to.
Now, Frank, how many presidents did you actually serve under?
Oh, three. Ford, Carter, and Reagan.
And can you give our audience kind of a thumbnail? Was this like one time a year you'd go decorate the tree?
Not at all.
Because you were jumping from Richmond Hill to Washington.
Washington, all the time, on the Eastern Shuttle. I would get a few days in advance. I did state dinners. I did parties. Mrs. Ford seemed to like me. And the White House staff liked me. And the chief usher. Now, the chief usher is the manager. He's the big honcho boss at the White House. And the name may not sound correct, like it being an usher, because I was a movie usher part-time. It ain't the same. The chief usher is the manager, a big boss at the White House. And they all liked me very much. I was young. I was a new kid on the block. And when I got this job to decorate the tree, there were people 40, 50, much older than me. You know, I was a kid on the block.
By the way, when you came into the White House, did they look at you and like, are you here as a delivery boy?
Yes, they had no idea. And I was 20, just turning 25. I was a young whippersnapper. I have a very youthful look. a youthful image.
You do, yes.
Yeah.
So that's worse, though, because now they're looking at you like a little kid.
Who's
and you're
kid?
Saying, I'm here to decorate the White House.
And the chief White House decorator said, he's the one that's that Mr. First Lady picked that we're going to decorate the tree. So these guys were my under me, but I treated them with the highest respect. And there was a man there. He was 75 years old. He was a floral designer. His name was Rex. And he told me, come here, kid, I want to talk to you. They call me the kid. And I accepted that. You know, I would never disrespect a senior. Because someday I know I will be one. He says to me, I'm still waiting to be a senior.
He's going to do a comedy act. Remember
the
comedy club guy we had on?
Yeah.
We're going to send you over there to him in Northport.
He says to me, come here, kid, I want to talk to you. Yes, sir. And I'm his boss. I was decorating the head tree. He says, take pictures. Take lots of photographs whenever you can. Because someday you're going to write a book, and you're going to talk about this at lectures, and you're going to be famous.
He predicted the future.
He predicted my future.
Did he say, my hometown, you'd be doing this?
No, he didn't quite say that,
okay.
But he said to me...
precise.
I said to myself, wow, that stayed in my mind. And now I think of it as of those years, so many years ago, over 40. I said, Rux was right. I mean, he was my angel. He was a guardian angel telling me to do all this. And I did what he said. I collected 500 photographs. And I picked out the best ones for my book. And I worked with the White House Historical Association, for over a year. And then I worked with the United States Army because I have the seal in my book. So between those two, it took me 2 years just to write the book. But I had to wait 30 years to write the book. One of those kiss and tell laws, you can't tell secrets.
I was going to say, that's going to be another form of question.
Yeah. So I had to wait 30 years to write the book. And there were so many people writing books, but they were much older than I was. So let them have their fame and glory. Someday I'll be in the spotlight.
Now, Frank, if someone hearing this, if they would either like to get your book or even have you come into their organization, I'm guessing like a Kiwanis club.
It'd be my honor. I've done that.
To come and speak, because you're delightful, you're funny, they're getting
Thank
a
you.
Comedian, they're getting an historian. How do people get in
Just
touch
Just go around
you?
My website, Frank Lazzaro, LAZZ as in zebra, ARO.com. Everything is there, the books, all the photographs of all my seminars.
And you live right here on Long Island.
I live in Levittown, New York.
Okay, so easy enough. So if anybody listening to this, if you'd like to have a delightful speaker, a lot of fun, and find out some secrets about the White House.
You can.
He'll give you all the secrets.
I'm a Legionnaire, too. I belong to the Levittown American Legion. I love that place. It has given me such strength, and I'm so proud to be part of the American
Legion. You decorate their Christmas tree too?
Well, not yet. I just got.
Come on, what are you waiting for?
I just joined about 3 months ago.
Oh, okay. I thought you sounded like a lifetime member.
They all got my book. I mean, many of them got my book, but I love the American Legion. It feels like I'm back in the Army, and I want that military. I always had that military discipline in me. You know, I'm up at 5 in the morning. I still eat SOS, you know.
No, we're on radio. Don't
say
anything.
I know.
Don't get us in trouble.
Cream chip beef. I mean, I love that on biscuits.
Speaking of that, Frank, I want to go back a little bit further. What was your military background? What were you exactly in Fort Bragg?
Well, that was MOS. That means military occupational specialty. I had three of them. I was infantry, which is 11 Bravo. So I learned how to combat. Then I went to jungle school, getting ready for Vietnam. And I went to Fort Polk, Louisiana. Now, Fort Polk is someplace, it's like the armpit of the world. I mean, it's Fort Polk is a tough place. I mean, they have a sign on the gate, last chance to go AWOL, you know? Because Fort Polk is a jungle land, it's swamps. And I took survival and jungle training for 3 months. And then I also did airborne training at Fort Bragg. That was my permanent home, Fort Bragg. Fort Bragg is an airborne post. Now, if you don't want to jump out of a plane, don't go to Fort Bragg. Because if you don't jump out of a plane, the guys in the barracks will not talk to you. So I had to, in Rome, you do what Romans do. So I learned to jump out of a plane at the Fort Bragg Skydiving Club. And at first, I had the rosary around me. You know, I'm Catholic, so I had the rosary. You know, I'm Italian, so I had garlic around my neck. You know, my aunts all was praying when my first jump, and was successful at 4,000 feet. So
this just gets
congratulations.
More and more
it does.
And the photographs are on my website, and also in my book of my first parachute jump.
Frank, this has been amazing. We have so many more questions for you, but at this point in the show, we're going to take a brief break from my hometown.